His name is Robert Targan. For years, he billed himself as a doctor, appealing to people around the country who suffer from facial paralysis. But prosecutors say what the real Bob Targan has practiced is deceit.
His crime was theft by deception and giving hope to vulnerable victims.
In September, Targan was convicted in Montgomery County Court on 24 counts of practicing physical therapy without a license, misrepresenting himself as a practitioner, and stealing from his patients.
We are not talking about small potatoes here. We're talking about something that was coordinated, widespread.
Targan's deceit, prosecutors say, included not just unlicensed care.
This is a TENS machine.
But unauthorized use of medical equipment as well. Targan rented this nerve stimulation device to patients, even though it's supposed to be dispensed only by a doctor.
So he was making money by them coming into his office, by him charging them, and then by him actually renting medical equipment to them. So he was making money a lot of different ways.
But the real story about Targan is how he managed to operate unchecked for so long. Ron Cole is a licensed physical therapist in Kentucky who once worked with Targan.
I was surprised it took this long for somebody to finally get him.
Indeed, Targan had come to the attention of Maryland regulators long before Montgomery County prosecutors went after him and took him to court. In the mid-1990s, the Maryland Board of Physicians got a complaint that Targan was practicing medicine without a license. At that time, he had a business called the Institute of Neurophysiology. The complaint could have triggered a criminal investigation of Targan then. It did not. The board issued a cease and desist order. Targan had to pay back Blue Cross Blue Shield, apparently for insurance payments he'd collected, but no other action was taken.
He never stopped using the claim to be a neurophysiologist. I don't think he paid attention to that order at all.
In fact, Targan went on to expand his business through a new company called the National Centers for Facial Paralysis. It formed in June of 1997, just 4 months after the Maryland Board of Physicians closed its complaint. Its purpose, clearly spelled out in corporate records, was to provide treatment for facial paralysis. By the time Ron Cole met Targan in 2000, he'd stretched his business nationwide.
They had clinics in 28 different states.
The record also shows Targan continued to use the title doctor. It showed up on business correspondence, it appeared next to his name on his office door, and he used it when he signed up for a $1 million business loan through Merrill Lynch. Merrill Lynch even featured Dr. Bob Targan in a company newsletter in the spring of 2002. All of this after Targan had come to the attention of the Board of Physicians. Targan later claimed he never meant to imply he was a medical doctorate. The title, he said, referred to a doctorate degree he said he had. But state regulators involved in the most recent investigation found otherwise. Targan claims that he has a PhD.
Yes, he does claim that.
True?
No, it is not true.
After several failed attempts to speak with him at his home, Targan contacted us this morning to again insist he has a PhD. He sent us this paperwork, a certificate from a place called Pacific Western University in California. Investigators say it's a brand new claim from Targan. Turns out Pacific Western was an unaccredited correspondence school that required no classroom instruction. In 2004, it was declared a diploma mill by federal investigators. Targan didn't mention that. The director of the physicians' board refused an on-camera interview, saying we were inquiring about something confidential and we weren't supposed to know about it. It seems other regulators weren't supposed to know either. In the most recent investigation, the Board of Physical Therapy Examiners asked the physicians' board for information, too.
We have not been able to find anything. They do not respond to even a subpoena from this board for information.
As part of this investigation?
Correct.
Federal authorities had also been tipped off about Targan by Ron Cole. Cole was among a number of physical therapists who conducted nerve tests on patients for Targan's firm.
I was being paid a flat fee by the NCFP to do this testing, and they in turn would bill the insurance companies for it.
But in 2002, Cole says he noticed irregularities with the numbers of tests the firm was billing for in one patient's case.
They appeared to me as if they were just pulled out of thin air.
Made up.
And made up and placed on the sheet. And I noticed that they had billed for 22 units of this testing.
When it should be?
Should have been 10.
10. Cole cut his ties with Targan and notified the FBI about his suspicion that Targan was committing insurance fraud.
I needed to blow the whistle on this guy.
Targan was sued by the Aetna Insurance Company, which accused him of misrepresenting himself as a doctor and submitting fraudulent insurance claims totaling $1.1 million over an eight-year period. The suit settled out of court. That was in 2004. Again, no other action was taken. Targan continued to operate until the joint investigation by the Board of Physical Therapy Examiners and Montgomery County that started last fall.
Well, the appropriate end of the story is that ultimately he never hurts anybody again. He does not give false hope.
Targan claims he did help people and said today some patients will back him up when he's sentenced in 2 weeks. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Jayne.